So here I keep the broken needles. I left my darn, whatchamacallit, Elmer's glue squeeze bottle at home. I thought I'd put it in the bag. So I had to get my big gallon out of glue. And I'm going to stick it in here with one of these broken needles. So that'll work just fine. If I can get it out of there. Oh, see, that's why I don't use that. So now I'm going to have to drip it in there. I'm going to put it on this. Go with that. Yeah, but see, it's taking longer. Ah. See how clingy? That'll work. So instead of doing that, I'll just do this. Get enough on there. Perfect. So I. And the glue. All right, now I'm going to add the body. So a nuthatch is 4.5 inches long. That's what Wikipedia said. So I printed out my bird, like a little more than 4.5, because this is what, 4x6 photo paper? So if this is 4 and this is 6, this is 4, this is 6, take this, it's about right, you know? So I'm just going to shape this kind of like the bird, right? Skinnier at the, towards the head. Shape it. Use your workhorse needle. Same. What you can do is, if you're working upside down, is turn your reference upside down. So now I'm backwards. Okay, so I'm going to work with my shape. And just draw with the needle. And this work it all sides so it doesn't become square. How do I know what the other side of the bird looks like? I make it up. And it's weird, I'm right-handed, so I rather do things facing to the right for some reason than to the left. It's harder to do it for myself anyway. I have to think more.
Yeah.
And I don't know if that's upside down or right side up. Oh well. Mercy. Turn my reference back over. Gets confusing. That's my belly. Okay. So now we're going to be this side then. There's some goobers in here. Come out. See, that bird is kind of shape and taper back. Taper back. So, this is too much here. So, put my head on, and we're starting to see a bird there. The head of the nuthatch is much thinner, skinnier, flatter. The belly comes right up underneath, right down through there. So I'll probably have to add comb your wool, poke it in the direction of your contour. You know what contour is? The curve. Follow the curve. Contour the head. Curve this up into his. Bend this thing any way you want it. I'm not going to turn the head on this one because it's my first one, so I want to get to know it, and then I can more movement. But this one, he's like a little charging, so see how his feet are at a distance, like, so it's like getting ready to take off there, so I'll probably just go ahead and make him look like that. He of this on this head. I'm gonna compress this down because I think he is smaller headed, which is fine. Beautiful blue gray. Trying to get this to go up in here. Make a smooth transition. See the needle, I'm laying it flat to push it. I still need that white needle to pull the hairs out. Got me three times today. That's three. Yeah. Make sure you don't bleed on your wool. All right, so see, that's starting to look better there. Pulling that this way. You can do that too. Oh, we got the Bachelor on tonight.
Oh boy.
How exciting. Hey. Today is what? Monday, January 25th. This month has flown by. What a roller coaster. See, that's kind of dipping. That's not good. I'll have to add more. But I'm going to do his tail first. What was that? Oh, that's my cap. All right. So, what is it? It's got a nice little brown on top. So, I'm going to start with the black felt tail. But look at how those wings fold in there. Just lovely, you know? And that one's coming over. Nice. This is what happens when you don't keep your felt in a separate bag. Or maybe I poked this one. Oh, I think I did. So, I'll just put that away. I was going to try doing something flat, but I didn't have the patience for it. Oh. Another real time saver is have all your tools laid out. So last time I measured the, this nuthatcher must be a short distance flyer because it's got a short tail. Maybe he's a flies in spurts, you know. So let's see, we'll measure the head from the end of the beak to the back of the head. It's that far. So look at that. It's like one head going up into that part of the body. So if my head is this big on my bird, to the beak, to the back of the head, I'm going to make my tail that long. So you just pick a measurement on your bird and measure against what you're going to make. So right about there. And I'm going to give it a little flare. Right? And that should do it. Oops. I'm going to cut it a little longer because I'm going to put wool on top and underneath. I'm not going to do wire in this. I'm going to do a double up. Which means I'm going to cut another one. Let's see, can I use this up?
You can't go home.
Go ahead. It doesn't have to be the same shape, maybe. Moving his tail for all you know.
You don't know me from
that. This curved around.
These hairbreads on the front stairs.
Oops.
Up those stairs in that little bathroom. It's where I did my homework.
Offset a little bit. Right? I'll curve those too. Cut that off there.
Leave home, you blue
that. I want more like that. So what I'm gonna do is cut here. Get in there. Like that. Right? And I can put that in there. Pull that over there.